Please lie on your back. Close your eyes. And lengthen your legs, all of you. Lie quietly. And cover your eyes. Place your right hand with your fingers on your forehead. Place your left hand on the fingers of your right hand so your nose lies in the angle formed by the two hands. The hands cover the eyes without pressing on the eyeballs. Pay attention that there's no force in your hands. Place your hands exactly as I described, so there's no pressure on the eyeballs. Your fingers cross and rest on the sides of your forehead. The fingers of your left hand are over the fingers of your right hand, so no light enters your eyes. Your hands press on your cheeks and your forehead, but not on your eyeballs. Make sure there's no light coming to your eyes. I see that not everyone is doing this as they should. Like that. Listen to what you're feeling. What do you see in the background of your eyes when they are closed? Where the light cannot come in. If you will be quiet, most people, we see the colors or shapes rather than just seeing black. If your nervous system is quiet and your eyes are good, especially with a quiet nervous system, you will see so dark that it's black like wet black velvet. It is very black, the whole background. On a hot, wet day like today, you will see red and blue and yellow. But you will see that through the lesson, the background becomes darker. As the eyes see more black, your muscles become more soft, the body becomes quiet, and the background becomes black. Your breathing becomes deeper and deeper. Why? It's because your optic nerve cannot sense anything except light, dark, and color. If you hit someone on the head and move his eye will see colors or shapes. The skin nearby feels the blow, but the eyes can only see colors or shapes. The excitation of the optic nerve evokes in the brain only sensations of color, light, and dark. The optic nerve continues to be excited if you are not seeing dark. It shows that your nervous system is not quiet. You may not be doing anything or feeling anything, and despite that, your optic nerve continues to perceive and receive impulses. That shows that your nervous system is not quiet. It is a way to see how you measure the quieting and calming down of your system. Try to find inside the background of your eyes the darkest point that you can and listen to that point. Pay attention that your crossed hands do not work hard. Don't make any effort in your hands or your elbows, arms, and your breathing. You don't need to push or force to cover your eyes. If you listen well, you will observe that you feel each breath. You can see each breath, feeling the changing brightness in what you see. Listen and be aware of the darkest point in the background. Listen and try to see black all around without too much exertion or vigor. If you do it with willpower, you will excite the system to work. Willpower and exciting the system changes the colors and you won't see black. You need not try, but simply listen. It will do it by itself. Keep your eyes closed, lower your arms down, and turn both eyes to the right. Move from the middle to the right. Look from the root of your nose and turn your eyes to the right as if you want to look near your ear, somewhere near the floor. Near the ear on the floor. Everything in this lesson will always be done with eyes closed, so keep your eyes closed. Look at the bridge of the nose and then back to the right ear. Come back and continue to do this slowly, slowly. Notice, what do you do when you look? Look with both eyes, look with both eyes, with closed eyes. Look near your right ear on the floor and return to look at the bridge of the nose. Do that many times. And now, do this movement fast. Fast. Look very quickly to the right and back to the middle. To the right and back to the middle. Do not move your head. You don't need to turn your head for this. Only your eyes. Stop for a moment. Stay with your eyes closed. You can change the position of your legs if you wish. You can stand your feet if it's difficult to lie your legs on the floor. Lengthen your legs after the rest. Notice what you feel in your face now. only because you only looked to the right, not to the left. If you listen, you will sense a difference between the feeling of your facial muscles on your right and left sides. Like that. And now do the same thing to the left. Look at the bridge of the nose and turn your eyes as if to see your left ear on the floor. Look back and forth several times. Sense how the eyes make sudden movements to the left and then return. Sense how your eyes do that. And now do the same movement very, very quickly. Look left quickly and return quickly. Like that. Leave that. Cover your eyes with your hands again and feel. Is something change in the background of your eyes? Is there something more black than previously? Is it, it needs to be darker. Even if there is color, it is darker than before. Leave it. And begin attending to something important. What are your eyes doing? Where are your eyes when you close them and lie quietly? Where do your eyes turn? Where are they? What do they do? Do not answer. Listen. You will see that no one knows beforehand, without prior knowledge. Your eyes do something very peculiar when you lie like this. It is something no one thinks about. Lie as if you are going to sleep with your eyes closed, and then look momentarily at the bridge of your nose and let it go. And again, look at the bridge of your nose. You can feel that your eyes move from the upper corners of your eyes to look at the bridge of your nose. When the muscles are quiet, your eyes cross upward like two horns, like when you lie to fall asleep. They go right, left, and up. When you look at the bridge of your nose, you feel that you shift your eyes from the upper corner to the bridge of the nose. Look at the bridge of your nose and stop looking. Your eyes will drift to the upper corners. In other words, the muscles pull your eyes for focusing to bring your eyes closer and closer. When these muscles stop working, your eyes turn right and left to the upper corners of your eyes. They do not look down. Try this a few times. You will see that this occurs. Everybody sleeps and everybody has eyes, but I never saw one person who can spontaneously give me the correct answer. Only physiologists who learn it from the book. Most people say something that doesn't correlate to reality. Like that. And now, try something similar to what you did before. Shift your eyes towards the ceiling. Keep your eyes closed and look at the ceiling. begin following a ball that moves on the ceiling and rolls to the right until it meets the wall. The ball travels down the wall until it meets the floor. The ball rolls on the floor until it meets your body. Follow the ball with your eyes. Watch it as it rolls back to the wall, travels up the wall. Watch it as it touches the ceiling again. Look at it as it rolls to the spot of the ceiling in front of your eyes. Does it return to the same point, which you thought in the front of my eyes? With most people, you will see one eye is better than the other. In the beginning, habits of holding the head hinders the person from knowing exactly where is in front of my eyes. If you observe a person, you can see that each eye does not aim as what is considered the front. The differences can be very large. Only with good, quiet eyes, the in front is the geometrical front. Check and see where you focus when you think in front of me. You will see that gradually we will become uncertain. You will start thinking that it needs to move, maybe 3 inches to the right or slightly to the left. It is difficult to say. This is exactly in front. The eyes hop from place to place. Only excellent eyes with quiet character come to the same exact point without hesitation each time. Move once again from the middle to the right and look up along the ceiling until you see the wall. Look along the wall down to the floor. Travel along the floor to your ear. Return looking at the ceiling and then look at the base of your nose, from the base of your nose to your ear. And see the difference between these two types of movement. One is far away at the ceiling and one is nearby, from the bridge of the nose to the ear. Look again at the ceiling, down the wall, along the floor to your ear, and return to gazing at the ceiling in front of your eyes. And now look from the base of your nose to your ear. You will see that the movement of your eyes as they travel from the nose to your ear is sudden. They jump or accelerate. At these points, your eyes lose the control for focusing. They don't see the whole way. Your eyes see only the initial point and the final point. Something else happens when your eyes look at the ceiling, along the walls and the floor to your ear. Your eyes move smoothly and continuously then. And now begin distinguishing between eyes that work well and those that don't. Eyes that work well have smooth, continuous movement, as if they are oiled. Their movements are so gradual and tiny that there is a feeling that the eyes are swimming. Eyes that don't work well, especially with people that wear glasses, move continuously only to a point and then they jump. When you look along the ceiling, down the wall, and along the floor, your intention is to find a place where your eyes suddenly hop. Try to improve that part. That will free the muscles of your neck because your head moves when your eyes move. If your eyes jump, your head jumps also. That indicates your vertebrae have the same difficulty as your eyes. Everyone, try for yourself. Carefully check if your eye movement is continuous, fluid, there and back. Now do the same thing to the left. Follow a ball with your eyes from the middle and listen to the location of middle on the ceiling. Start from the same point on the ceiling and return your eyes to the left. Look to the left along the ceiling until you reach the wall. Look down the wall until you reach the floor. Look along the floor until you reach your body. And return, check if the movement of your eyes remain continuous and fluid the whole way. Observe if you feel any shaking, jumps, or hops in your eyes. It should not be that way. Slowly you can learn to control your eyes so they stop jumping. You will discover that it is worthwhile to do so. Here also, on this side, try to look from the bridge of the nose to the left ear in return. And then continuously from the ceiling to the wall on your left, let your eyes travel down the wall until you reach the floor, along the floor to your left ear. Return to the point in front of your eyes along the same path, and then look from the bridge of the nose to your left ear. And now move from ear to ear without following along the ceiling and walls. That means you look from the bridge of your nose to your right ear, immediately look to your left ear, return to your right ear, go back and forth with fast sudden movements. Go back and forth quickly, right, left, right, left. And now do the opposite. Look to your right ear, from your right ear up to the ceiling. Let your eyes travel along the ceiling until they see the wall. Travel down the wall to the floor. Look along the floor until you reach your right ear. Return using the same path to the ceiling. Pass the middle and begin looking to your left. Look along the ceiling until you reach the wall on your left. Look down the wall on your left until you reach the floor. Look along the floor until you reach your left ear, and then return to the ceiling. Know when you pass the middle point. Move from ear to ear with a continuous fashion. In a continuous fashion. Pay attention to these places where your continuity is not sufficient, where your eyes hop. At these points, you will notice the jumps. Cover your eyes again. Don't press with your hands, but listen. Choose the darkest, blackest point. Try making the whole background black from that point. See if you can do this with thinking so the entire background stays completely black like wet black velvet. Leave that. Keep your eyes closed. Press your eyes closed with all force. Use your eyebrows, eyelids, everything very forcefully. Press as if you wanted to bring your eyes into your eye sockets. Hold your eyes contracted for a few moments and leave it alone. Pause and then do it again. you imagine you're going to push your eyes deeper and deeper into their eye sockets. As I said, during rest periods, you can place your feet standing on the floor if it becomes difficult. Lengthen them after the rest periods. A few times, press your eyes inside your eye sockets, 20, 30 seconds, and let them go. And now, continue doing the same thing, but only with your right eye. Press only your right eye into its eye socket and let it go. Put your tips of your fingers delicately on your left eye to check that you don't do anything with your left eye while you're pushing your right eye. Contract with your eyebrow, eyelid, eye, and eyeball. Make it smaller and push it inside. And then let it go a few times. Make sure the left eye does not participate in this work. The left eye is restful. Begin doing the same thing with your left eye only. Press your left eye into its socket for 20 seconds and then let it go. Then repeat. Like that. Leave that. Cover your eyes with your hands as before. Do you see more black than before? Like that. Lower your hands and imagine a small black ball the size of a pea. It lies on the bridge of your nose between your eyebrows. Look at the ball and follow it as it travels down along your nose, between your nostrils. Follow it as it travels over your upper lip, your lower lip. The ball will roll down your chin, below your chin, to your throat and neck. Look at it as it rolls along your chest, all the way to your navel, your belly button, and then it comes back, it returns up your chest, to your neck, to your throat, pass over the lower lip, the upper lip, it reaches your nose again. Observe as it rolls up the bridge of your nose to the space between your eyebrows and roll along the exact middle of your forehead to your hairline. Look at it as it rolls onto the floor above your head, and from there the ball rolls exactly in the middle to the wall directly above your head. At this point, the small black ball returns. Do it slowly several times. Notice the continuity of the movement. It needs to be a continuous, fluid movement without any stops or jumps. And now do the same movement very quickly, as fast as you can. Let the ball move as if it suddenly became a wild ball. Do it at the fastest speed possible. Notice. On which points do you skip when you do it quickly? What do you not look at when you do it rapidly? You will discover that this is personal. Not everyone skips exactly at the same parts, but you skip those parts where your eye muscles don't work well normally. Leave it for a moment. Begin imagining a white ball instead of the black one. The white ball is bigger, the size of a ping pong ball, placed exactly at the same place on the bridge of your nose. So imagine the white ping pong ball, and then imagine the black ball in the same place. So replace the pea-sized black ball with a white ping pong ball. Attend to what you do with your eyes when you think about one and then change to the other. You will see that you do something different with your eyes as you imagine one or the other. And now, let the white ball slowly go up to the ceiling from the bridge of your nose. Let it travel up to that place in the middle we talked about on the ceiling, and then return the ping pong ball to the area between your eyes. Follow its movement with your eyes. Watch it as it goes up and when it goes down. Pay attention here too, that you don't jump, but make the movement continuous. The ball will rise with the same speed and lower with the same speed. Like that. And now imagine a large letter, like the big letter Q. Look at the white inside this letter. Let that letter lie on your face directly in front of your eyes. Slowly, slowly, move this letter away from your face in the direction of the ceiling. Move it directly through the middle path. Observe that the letter Q becomes smaller as it moves away from your face. Continue moving it away until you see a tiny black dot. Then return closer to your face until you see the black outline and the white inside. Return until you even see the little line to the right that makes it Q rather than an O. Look at the white area and then let the letter lie on your face. Move the letter away and let it become smaller again. Move the letter and make it smaller proportionally as it goes further away. Move it so far away that you see only a tiny black dot and you cannot discern what letter it is. Then bring it back to your face when it is only a small black dot. Bring it back until it becomes bigger and bigger and you recognize the letter Q. Let the letter rest on your face again. Do that a few times, slowly, slowly. Like that. Cover your eyes with your hands again. And slowly listen again if your eyes are quieter. Is it darker than before? Did the whole background become black, or at least blacker than before? Lower your hands and remain quiet. Each person by himself should take 2 minutes to review the movements you did. Repeat anything you remember. See if the movement is different from what you did before. Is the movement more continuous? Is it easier? Do you feel what you're doing with greater clarity? Everything we did, the movement with the balls, the right and left. Remember pushing the eyeballs into your eye sockets? Can you remember doing it with one eye and then the other? Do you remember finding the middle? Each one should do whatever you can remember. If you notice any difference from before, notice. It may be easier or more comfortable, it may be more difficult. What in these movements became different? Like that. Leave it. And slowly, slowly let your eyes open. Sense, what do you see differently on the ceiling? The shadows, the shapes. Do you see more details like shades and hills and valleys? Do you see more contrast than before? Slowly roll to the side. Take your time until you stand on your feet and notice, where do you feel different in your body?